game. The predecessor of puzzles, and it is considered the oldest puzzle of all times. It probably resulted from one of Archimedes' mathematical problems or the opposite. It is also referred to as bona fide, as its pieces are made of ivory. It's a square puzzle with geometrical shapes divided into 14 pieces, which are meant to be rearranged properly so as to form another figure or create their own structures. The pupils are divided into groups and become little investigators and learn about geometrical shapes through the game, while at the same time they are asked to cooperate, communicate, and expand their imagination and creativity. In the mathematical problem, Archimedes proves that for each one of the 14 pieces, the surface of the square is an integral multiple of the surface of every piece.
The pupils were instructed on how to use a loom in the classroom and got to discover how cloth was made in the past. In this way, they came in contact with a traditional Greek weaving tool used by women in the past.
The idea originated in language class. The pupils saw a picture of a loom in their course book in a unit which gave information about different museums.
Math was also used in the process, since the pupils were asked to use numbers and length units in order to measure the thread. They used and make their own creation.
We are the pupils of the third grade, and we are presenting the three of the historical inventions.
Protector of and continent messages, tachygraphy, skeins, catapult,
steam engine, the Ανικήθυρα με κάνεις. Wonder vending machine.
It was an ingenious wine cup which had a line that determined the limit of fulfillment and an axial or curved siphon. Pythagoras wanted to teach his students the necessity of moderation in our lives. It is also called the cup of justice.
When the limit was exceeded, lost was not only that which exceeded the limit, but also that which had been acquired up to then.
Let's see this in action.
We fill the cup with wine up to the line.
Once we submit the line, we will also lose what we have acquired so far.
pupils of third grade also worked on the same topic. Our goal was to learn about moderation and self-control.
We use a cutter to form a cross shape on the bottom of the cup.
We expand the cross with the help of a pencil.
We insert a straw.
We bend the straw up to the bottom of the cap.
We put silicone around the straw.
We cut the extra part of the straw.
We pour the cold water up to the straw without going over it so that it is even.
Once the leaven is surpassed, everything is lost, all the liquid is spilled.
This is the leaven. It is a precursor of the contemporary leaven and had the form of the leidere, which its Greek name derived. It was used for the construction of the ziggurats in Mesopotamia, the pyramids in Egypt, and the temples of the Greeks. It verifies the horizontality or the inclination of the surfaces.
The hovering ram of Ger. It was constituted by protected scaffold or wheels, and the rams were suspended with ropes from a central beam. The rams were long wooden beams that were used to demolish enemy walls.
The operators pulled the ram backwards with ropes and then released thus. Thus the hovering ram struck the stones with force, breaking or overturning them.
An ingenious method for visual message transmission, letter-letter, between mountains which were at a distance of up to 100 kilometers. It was invented by Cleoxenus and Democritus.
Beacons were built on carefully chosen mountains. Each beacon consisted of 2 volts at the height of a man with 4 torch holders on the one and 6 torch holders on the other.
Moreover, both beacon operators had at their disposal 4 plates with letters of the alphabet inscribed on them, divided into sets of 6. The 4 lights on the left-hand side of the transmitter's beacon determined the plate number which had the desired transmitter letter.
The 4 lights on the right-hand side refer to the desired transmitted letter of that specific plate. For example, if 2 torches were put up on the left wall and 3 on the right wall, this corresponded to the transmission of the letter I.
Αφήστε το. Αφήστε.